Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to IBM's software servers announcement. As you may have guessed from the invitation, our theme today is about taking giant leaps. Certainly since the early 70s, technology has taken giant leaps. In 1969, to pick a year at random, computing... That's a hint, isn't it? Computing was centralised on large mainframes, with centralised data and applications, all serving hundreds of unintelligent terminals. In the 80s, the microprocessor made the personal computer a reality, which introduced the era of shrink-wrap software and local area networks. And in the 90s, client-server, the internet, and group computing were born. Back to that random year, 1969. In 1969, many of you probably don't remember back then, but back in 1969, a client was a customer. And a server was what John Newcomb did when Tony Roach wasn't. And a network was nothing more complicated than a large television station. But in 1969, we also took a giant leap, and we're about to take some more.
Thank you. I'm Neil Armstrong. Our hosts have very kindly presented me the privilege of joining you today in conjunction with their launch of a very exciting new project. Gives me a chance to reminisce about the subject of launches, which have been more than slightly important in my life. It's time to move on. The pre-flight preparations are complete. It's time to initiate the launch. And to begin the countdown, I'm pleased to introduce Craig Allen. Craig.
Thanks, Neil. Thanks for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Neil Armstrong. My name is Captain Craig Allen of the Starship IBM Enterprise. Computer off. Lock off. And I'd like to now reintroduce you to Mr. Doug Elix, who's the proud father of the first Australian on the moon and the managing director of IBM Australia here today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Captain Craig. Do you ever wonder what it's like to have to manage a person like that in your own company? What did you think of that handheld device? Isn't that absolutely amazing? What you don't realise is it's the same 7-digit numeric register output device that Neil Armstrong used. But Craig has this ability to be able to instantly convert from binary numbers into alphabets. What an amazing talent. Would you like him? Anyhow, so much for 2010. Welcome back to 1996.